The comics industry releases dozens of new products every week, so it would be very difficult for a beginner to figure out where to start. Many comics have received an adaptation and are now twice as popular. We want to get into this industry and figure out which comics really deserve attention. Today on Facts in Box, we'll look at 8 of the most significant comics. DC, The New Frontier. Our list opens with DC, The New Frontier comic strip. Darwin Cook writes and draws the comic. Drawing is the hallmark of this comic. The style of the artist is somewhat reminiscent of the cult Bruce Timm and Jack Kirby. The drawing is ideally suited to the atmosphere of the comic. The action takes place in an alternate universe, with events surrounding the Green Lantern Hal Jordan, Martian Hunter John Johns, and Flash Barry Allen, who are just starting their superhero careers. As for the retired Justice Society, Superman and Wonder Woman work for the government, and Batman is hiding from the authorities. In this world, superheroes are one of the most discussed topics, as they are closely watched by the whole world. The setting of the Cold War and the fears caused by it is beneficial for the comic strip, demonstrating to itself the real social state of things in society, and at the same time, integrating people with amazing abilities into the society. The Sandman. The Sandman comic book series can be fallen in love with just from the covers alone. The series was written by Dave McKean. Each cover is really abstract, but at the same time symbolic, and executed in dark colors so masterfully that it could be proudly hung on the wall. In addition, The Sandman can easily become one of the most unusual works you read. The story tells of Morpheus. He is one of the seven greats. There is also death, passion, suffering, fate, madness, and crush. Each of the greats has absolute power within its aspect, and may also slightly influence its opposite. Of course, the Lords of Aspects are far from at odds with each other, and people appear in the plot to build their intrigues. It's on the complex relationships of the seven that the whole plot is built. Neil Gaiman, the main screenwriter of the comic, is generally not far from trivial ideas, and this non-triviality is especially noticeable in the characters. They don't even have a permanent personality and appearance. The history itself is large scale. It contains monumental things and events like the creation of life and the essence of the universe. For example, you can find out who existed in the endless space at the time when Earth was completely uninhabited, and get acquainted with personified stars. Watchmen. Alan Moore was able to make a story that works great in its format. Together with the artist Dave Gibbons, they check every frame of the comic book and think out every panel of it. Moore used history as a means of reflecting the social problems of the time and criticizing the concept of superheroes. The action of the comic takes place in an alternate reality of the 1980s, where superheroes appeared in the 1940s to 1960s and helped the United States win the war in Vietnam. A few years later, the United States is on the verge of a nuclear war with the USSR, and costumed heroes are outlawed, and most of them are retired. But some continue to secretly work for the government. The plot is based on an investigation into the murder of a former hero, funded by the government, which, in the end of the comic strip, reveals the terrifying truth and the death of millions of people in order to prevent a nuclear war. A distinctive feature of the novel is its non-linear narrative structure. Gibbons arranged 9 frames per page, and also used repeated characters, such as a bloody yellow emoticon. All issues except the last include additional fictitious documents, articles, books, photographs, newspaper clippings, etc. These take place in the described fictional world and tell the background of events. Starting with the 3rd chapter, the plot is intertwined with another comic strip, The Legends of the Black Schooner, which is read by a boy near a newsstand. Watchmen received positive reviews from both specialized comic books and the mass media. The novel is considered one of the best in the history of comics and has been awarded many awards along with the creators. Death Note. The Death Note manga is the greatest detective work of the 21st century. This is the story of a grand psychological duel between two rivals and a picture of the construction of a nightmare dystopia. The literature can be argued only by the hyperboloid of Engineer Garin by Alexei Tolstoy, the greatest detective work of the 20th century. Death Note is Obata's best work. Each frame of this manga is the embodiment of the professional pride of this artist, who believes that every detail in his comics should be drawn not only better than everyone in Japan, but also better than everyone in the world. Each panel on every page should be so quality that you can hang it on the wall as a work of art. The plot was based on the philosophical idea, is it possible to achieve good for some people by killing others? The author came up with an original story that reflects the essence of what could be in the world if a person could kill others with impunity in order to make the lives of others better. Tsugumi Oba considers the reaction of the killer himself, his motives and desires, and the reaction of society to the actions of the killer. Death Note appeared before readers for the first time in the form of a manga in December 2003 as a pilot volume, and in February 2004 as the beginning of the main plot in the weekly Shonen Jump magazine. The manga continued to be published until May 2006 and contained 108 chapters, later published in 12 volumes, Tank Booms, in Japan. Later came the 13th volume, a kind of encyclopedia on the world of Death Note from the authors. The idea of the manga formed the basis of two paired feature films released in the Japanese cinemas in June, Death Note, and November 2006, Death Note, Last Name. V for Vendetta. This comic is often remembered for the famous mask of Guy Fawkes. He first became a symbol of the protests against corruption and power in the West, and then a ubiquitous internet meme. They borrowed it from the beautiful work of Alan Moore, who created one of the best dystopias on the page of comics. Of course, we're talking about the comic strip V for Vendetta. The comic book takes place in the dystopian Great Britain of the 1980s and 1990s. The plot is based on the story of a mysterious revolutionary who calls himself V, who is trying to destroy the totalitarian regime with the support of the people. In 2006, Warner Bros. Released a film based on the comic. The series of the comics describes the near future of Britain after a nuclear war that destroyed most of the world. The bulk of the damage in the country was caused by the consequences of the war, floods and crop failures. In this future, the fascist North Fire Party destroyed its rivals in concentration camps and now rules the country, turning it into a police state. V, an anarchist revolutionary wearing a Guy Fawkes mask, begins a complex, brutal, and intentionally theatrical campaign to kill his former captors, overthrow the government, and convince people that they can rule themselves. The visual authorship of David Lloyd perfectly fits the story. London is shown as gloomy and dirty, and the protagonist himself is often completely surrounded by shadows. However, I have a confession to make. I don't like the drawings in V for Vendetta. David Lloyd worked on the drawings much more thoroughly than many modern authors. The panels are consistent, the movement of characters and dynamic scenes can be traced with ease because there is an abundance of shadows. The figure appears too noisy to me, but I note once again that this helps to penetrate the atmosphere of the anti-utopian world of Alan Moore. Avengers. This is an elite comic book superhero team from Marvel Comics. It was created by writer Stan Lee and artist Jack Kirby and first appeared in the Avengers comic strip in September 1963. The Avengers, later nicknamed the most powerful heroes on the Earth, originally consisted of Ant-Man, Wasp, Thor, Iron Man, and the Hulk. However, from the very beginning, changes began to take place in the team. The Hulk soon left the Avengers and Captain America joined them. The changing roster became the team's calling card, although some constancy still persisted. The Avengers fought with such enemies that no superhero could defeat alone. This was the signature phrase, "Avengers, assemble!" Throughout the entire existence of the team, people, mutants, robots, gods, aliens, supernatural creatures, and even former villains visited its ranks. In 1963, the Avengers made their debut in their own comic book series dated September of that year. The series lasted 404 issues, from September 1963 to September 1996. Later, new comics of this group were released, which are still popular today. The Invisibles. If you want to understand what Grant Morrison actually tried to express in his comic, The Invisibles, you should take into account that he received most of his inspiration after aliens from Kathmandu kidnapped him and gave him ideas for the comic. Yeah, he actually said that. The book itself tells about a group of people working for the Invisible College, a secret organization fighting the race of alien gods who want to stop the metaphysical evolution of mankind by enslaving it. A mixture of anarchy and existential overtones with high ideas of incoherent delirium under the influence of acid makes The Invisibles the most difficult to understand work of Morrison. But if you fully understand it, it will also become the most amazing and charming comic you read. Well, really, how can you not like a book on a topic so dear to our hearts as an alien invasion that at the same time focuses on tantric sex and drug use? Morrison is more famous for his experiments with superheroes in series like Batman Arkham Asylum and New People X, but this is the same as comparing Betty with Veronica. And in the end, everyone who seeks to explore the darkest corners of comic book cultures dives into these psychedelic waters. Sin City. You've probably already seen the movie, but believe me, Sin City is more than just a movie. The bloody neo-noir world of Frank Miller, where violence and drug trafficking reigns, is one of the most extensive and detailed of all that has ever been in comics. The black and white sketch of the book resembles cheap stories from the 1940s, but Miller easily refutes this. His tough dialogue just oozes testosterone, while the internal monologues of his characters emphasize their mental anguish and suffering, which is perfect for this environment. Everyone knows characters like Marv, Nancy, and Dwight from the movie, but they really came to life in the comics. Combining minimalism and negative space in his own style, the Millerovsky Sim City seems to be coming off the pages. In modern comics, this visual style is no longer used. Have you ever read any of these comics? Let us know in the comments below. We read every single comment we get. And remember to like and subscribe. Until next time on Facts in Box.